Vectorizing images downloaded from Midjourney is crucial for creating high-quality coloring books. Unfortunately, as many of you have noticed, Vectorizer AI is no longer free. I personally use Adobe Illustrator to vectorize Midjourney images because I design all my low-content book covers and interiors with it, making it the most practical choice for me. However, I understand that Adobe Illustrator is not accessible to everyone, and many of you are searching for free Vectorizer AI alternatives. In this video, I will share with you a currently free tool that will allow you to turn any AI-generated coloring page or Midjourney image into vectors. Besides this, at the end of the video, I will show you a bonus feature of this tool that you can use while creating cover pages for your coloring books. Let's dive in. SVG Converter is a free online tool for converting raster images into vector graphics. To use it, simply drag and drop your JPEG or PNG onto the homepage. This will open the editing window. On the left, you will see the original raster file, which looks very pixelated when zoomed in. On the right, you will see the vectorized results. There is a sidebar with various settings that I will explain soon. The default settings work well and produce a decent result. To show you the results of this tool quickly, I will display the vectorized versions of three different image styles I created in Midjourney using the default settings. The first Midjourney image is a simple line art illustration designed for coloring pages, which I showed in my previous Midjourney consistent character video. Once you upload the image, it will be displayed on the left canvas. The right canvas shows the vectorized outcome. Simply click the vectorize button. If you zoom in, you will notice that the right side is a vector without any pixelation. On the left side, we see pixels because it's a raster image. If you are satisfied, you can download the vector in formats such as SVG, AI, EPS, or PDF. Vectorizing such line art images is generally straightforward because their clear and distinct lines are well suited for conversion into vector paths. As a result, you can achieve good results using various vectorizing tools. If you are interested in converting Midjourney or other AI-generated simple line art images into vectors, I recommend considering SVG Converter as a free and suitable alternative to Vectorizer AI. The second Midjourney image is a flat vector art illustration of a UFO. Vectorizing flat vector art illustrations is also easy because these images already have clear shapes and solid colors that are straightforward for vectorizing software to process. The process is efficient and typically produces accurate results with minimal adjustments needed. However, as you can see, there are some parts that need to be fixed. One of the good features of the SVG Converter is that you can edit the image and fix these issues. But before we explore the image editing feature, let's go through all the functionalities one by one. By default, when you first upload an image, the color option is turned on, and unlimited is selected. But what does unlimited do? Well, the unlimited option automatically generates the maximum number of colors in the vector. This approach gives the best results for real-life images and photographs. However, for images with a limited number of colors, I recommend creating a custom color palette. To do this, click on the custom option. Here you can either enter a specific number to generate a palette or manually pick colors from the image itself. By testing different number of colors based on your image, you may get better results for your purpose. Now I will show you how to edit the vectorized image and fix the artifacts. These artifacts can occur during the vectorization process due to the imperfections in the original raster image or limitations of the vectorization software. To fix the artifacts, we need to manually edit the segmented image. The segmented image serves as an intermediate result. Click the Edit Image icon here. Clicking this opens an image editor with essential editing tools. Here you will find different versions of the segmented image. You can jump to a previous revision if needed. Use this feature to switch between the vector and raster views. In the pan canvas, you can move around similar to what you would find in other image editors. The color fill tool allows you to fill areas with color, while the edit pixel tool, similar to a pencil, is useful for precise edits. The color picker makes it easy to select colors. Remember that Ctrl plus Z is for undo and Ctrl plus Y is for redo. To fix the artifacts, pick the neighborhood color, click the Edit Pixel tool, and fill in the necessary parts. Click Save. When you do, a new option becomes visible, indicating that the segmented image is selected. Keep it turned on. Finally, click Vectorize. It looks better now. If you spend some time, you can make it even better. I believe that if your final printed area is not too large, you will be satisfied with the results from the SVG converter. However, be cautious, it might not be good enough for use on print-on-demand products with a larger print area, such as t-shirts or paper posters. That's why I prefer using Adobe Illustrator to achieve a more professional result when vectorizing images. Let me show you the outcome of vectorizing the same image in Adobe Illustrator. The process is straightforward and fast, requiring just a few clicks. Select the image and click on Window in the top menu. Choose Image Trace from the menu. This will open the Image Trace panel. When the image is selected, you will see that the options in the Image Trace panel become available. At the top of the panel, you will find the basic options. You can expose additional options by turning the triangle next to the advanced label. I chose 16 colors in SVG converter, that's why I will also choose 16 colors here in the preset menu to compare the results between the two different tools. Finally, click on Expand in the top menu. That's it. Once you are satisfied, choose File, Export, Export As, select a location for the file, and enter a file name. Then select the file format as PNG and choose High Resolution. Okay, let me show you the difference in results between SVG Converter and Adobe Illustrator. As you can see, the result from Adobe Illustrator looks more professional and smooth. When you use Adobe Illustrator to vectorize your images, you will be able to modify them as needed, ensuring perfection for any print-on-demand project, regardless of the printing area. That's why I recommend trying Adobe Illustrator for creating more professional low or medium content books, all in one place. There's a 7-day free trial available. I will include the link in the description, so you can test it after watching this video. Lastly, I want to show you the result for the third image, which is a photorealistic image of the Eiffel Tower. I continue with the unlimited color setting, as it is a photorealistic image. However, keep in mind that vectorizing photorealistic images isn't easy due to their complex details and numerous colors, which can be challenging for software to handle accurately. The process often requires manual adjustments to achieve good results. As you can see, the SVG converter did a good job with such a detailed image. However, when we compare it with the result from the Adobe Illustrator, once again, Illustrator outperformed in terms of details and overall quality. Now, let me introduce a bonus feature of SVG Converter that you can use when creating cover pages for your coloring books. In my previous video, I was unable to colorize this character using Midjourney prompts and had to resort to Adobe Illustrator's Live Paint Bucket tool. However, I discovered that SVG Converter's color fill feature can achieve the same results. So, after vectorizing the image, click the Edit Image button. Next, click Custom Picker and choose the color you prefer. Finally, click Color Fill to dye the area you want. It's as simple as that. By the way, make sure all the endpoints in your dyeing area are connected. For example, if you color the face, it will also affect the eye area because the endpoints aren't connected. To fix this, click on Edit Pixel and connect the endpoints. Then, try dyeing the face again. You see, it works quite well. Okay, finally, I believe that SVG Converter is a good free vectorizer AI alternative for vectorizing raster images into vector graphics. As I demonstrated, if you are converting line art images for coloring pages, SVG Converter performs well. When it comes to flat vector art illustrations, you can also use SVG Converter with some editing depending on your purpose and desired final product. However, if you need more professional results, I recommend using Adobe Illustrator. I will provide links below for both SVG Converter and Adobe Illustrator. I hope this video was helpful. If you found it useful, please consider subscribing and liking the video to support the channel. See you soon.